Before we became the Vancouver City Champs, let's just rewind just a little. This game occurred in late September, and it was probably one of the worst games I've ever played in my life, to be honest, and yeah, you'll see. I don't know why I pushed him, but that happened to be my first yellow card, and if you didn't know, in soccer you get a warning, which is the yellow card, and if you get another one, that's a red card. So this is where I got my second yellow card leading into the red, and yeah, it was just a night that I did not want to remember, and I felt ashamed, and yeah, I don't know. I even decided to quit soccer for a little bit, but you'll see what happens. Shame is a terrible emotion, and one of the strongest and most destructive ones that there is. I realized it was a very hard thing to overcome by yourself. Even though I felt ashamed and embarrassed, I did understand that my actions on the field were unacceptable and that I had let my team down. I couldn't believe that I had let my emotions get the best of me. And yeah, during that period, I thought I was going to quit soccer because I was so embarrassed to even show up at practices and games. And I didn't really care about soccer anymore, but I realized to regain my love for the sport, I first focused on reminding myself of the reasons why I fell in love with it in the first place. I reminded myself of the joy, excitement, and the sense of accomplishment that it brings me. I overcame my embarrassment and shamefulness by first acknowledging and accepting my feelings. It was a hard process, but I got through it and it was worth it. I recognized that it was normal to feel embarrassed and ashamed in certain situations, and that it was not going to be a reflection of my worth as a person. I then worked on reframing my thoughts and my perspective, shifting my focus from my mistakes and shortcomings to my strengths and accomplishments. By taking these steps, I was able to let go of the embarrassment and shamefulness and move forward with confidence and self-assurance. I started to train every day individually, maybe not every day, but whenever I could, to try and get better every single day. And I learned that if you take chances, make mistakes, that's how you're gonna grow. I was training by myself individually and with my team, so I was getting better by the day, and it showed. So I wanted to talk about one more thing, something that isn't talked about enough, and it is the athlete's mental health. A student athlete's mental health is important because it can affect their performance and overall well-being. Mental health issues such as anxiety and depression can negatively impact an athlete's ability to focus and perform at their best. Additionally, the high pressure and intense scrutiny that athletes face can lead to increased stress and emotional strain. Furthermore, athletes often have to deal with setbacks, injuries, and retirements, which can also take a toll on their mental health. Therefore, it is important for athletes to have access to mental health resources and support in order to maintain a healthy balance between their physical and mental well-being. As said before, when I got that red card, my mental health was not there, and yeah, I feel like I was juggling a variety of duties and responsibilities, and it was just too much for me to handle. And although I still felt that shamefulness and disappointment from others, I stayed positive. I realized that I can make a mistake and come back from it. Something I learned from this journey is that people mistakenly believe that the challenging part of sports is the physical, but in reality it's the mental aspect, such as confidence, recovering from injuries and strain. So my essential question was, how can I overcome the mental issues in my sport to become a better player? There are many ways to get through these mental issues in soccer, like seek help, but I wanted to overcome this issue by myself, and I set realistic goals, I stayed positive, and I took care of my body. What really helped me the most was recognize the issue. The first step I overcame is to acknowledge that they exist. Recognize that my thoughts, emotions, and behavior are affecting my performance and that I need to take action to improve my health. After that break, where I mainly focused on my mental health, I became a better player mentally and physically, and it showed in my games. Thanks for coming along on my journey. Let's look at the results now.
Shoot!
Your name wanna fly. Yeah. They wanna tame your desire, but you light it up, now your aim getting higher. At the way.